know all the set of circumstances which led you to stand on your feet today, but you are very courageous. I do know one of the hardest things is when someone gets injured at work. And injuries can come in various forms. Don't believe that this is a safe country. A couple of hundred people each year die traumatically at work. They leave home and they never come home. There's nearly 3,000 Australians who will die this year because of industrial diseases. But it doesn't just stop there. You've got psychological injuries. Now, some of the newspapers like to rubbish psychological injuries. But you've got back pain. Say you've got compressed discs, it is a common enough injury. You've been lifting. Say you're a nurse or an orderly, or you've worked, you know, you're a carpet layer, or you've worked as a brickie, and your back gives out. Now, you can't see that person's injuries. They look hale and hearty. But if anyone's ever had real pain, you know you can't lift your grandkids. You know that your mobility is restricted. Pain is a bugger because, you know, if you lost a finger, people can be sympathetic. Oh, you've only got four fingers. But pain, with the best will in the world, the rest of us can't see. And once you've got that injury, injuries are very often permanent. And we've got a system in this country, and it's evolved sadly over the last couple of decades, because once you've been off work for a couple of years, that's it. You're out of the workers' comp system, and you're left to fend to yourself on the Commonwealth pension, the disability pension, and you've got to try and find the money for your medical costs. An injury in this country of a permanent nature can lead to permanent poverty. And then you've got the mental stress that goes with it. You don't want to be a pain, or you don't want to be always saying, I have a problem. The human condition is want to get is by and large, we want to get on with our fellow people. You don't be the one with a complaint. It's very isolating having an injury. When you're not at work and you're stuck at home, you've got to take your meds, and you're made to feel like somehow you're the problem. Sure. One in every 100 people probably is brought in the system. But I'm just made differently to some of those liberals. I'm not obsessed about the one, they shouldn't do that. But I am obsessed about the 99 who don't get a straight ticket. The legal system in this country is very difficult when you're the plaintiff, when you're the complainant. It is a really tiring, tortuous process. You know, you say, what will be done? A lot of the workers' comp systems are run by the states. But we wanted to create national occupational health and safety laws, but a couple of liberal state governments opposed that. I do think it's over time in this country for a national rehabilitation strategy. By that, what I mean is, just because you've got an injury doesn't mean that you should be discarded and put on the, you know, the scrap heap and given the best pay. I can promise you that a Labor government, a Shorten Labor government, we'll work on national rehabilitation. We'll work with the doctors to educate them. We'll work with employers. We'll work about what is best practice. As a country, Mary, we cannot afford to lose your knowledge. We cannot afford to discard your heart. We cannot afford to discard your honesty. It is a lazy country which says that once you've got an injury, you're in the too hard basket. So that's why I think you're courageous to speak.